So first step is you have to change the beautiful studio. We provide the tools how you change everything. For example, I can make a landscape view with any city there or whatever the beautiful scenery you can put in the background, and then it becomes like a studio in front. The floor you can change whatever. Anyway, the idea is if he start talking about the PowerPoint, you load the PowerPoint file here, and as soon as you move the mouse here, this one become big. So as soon as any students make a question from online, you just move this one. So we make a zoom with a speech mode, and speech become bigger and smaller. So automatically they show this. And because the teacher always become big when teachers speak, we recognize this is a speaker mode. And then they bring the speaker in the front. So they are making this kind of a scene like this. So all the students watching teachers' emotions, gestures there. And then whenever he moved the pointer to the PowerPoint, whatever, it goes to here. And furthermore, we have a titling function. So the note is showing on this title. So the summarizing each slide, they have a titling going here. So that way we make a new way of presentation on online. Even you can show this one in the projector screen. So students always have big teacher face. For example, especially in this conference hall, like the 200 people sitting, the professors, teachers, speaker, too small. But when you make it this way, beautiful screen coming out and a big screen. And also we can broadcast in real time. So they are smartphone showing here. So they don't have to watch there, they can watch here. So that way I want to make a new way of presentation from everywhere.
Also have like telepresence of students, yeah. Because I see the desks.
Yeah, of course. The students they can use the Zoom, whatever. But they don't need any device. They just need a mobile phone. They can join here.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
This is basically everything that the teacher would see. Everything on the right screen.
Yeah. But normally using notebook, we recommend to have two more monitor, one presenting material, document sharing, whatever is this one showing there, and also Zoom, and operation the notebook. That's a new classroom,
yeah.
Where they can show. So what's you doing?
I'm here as representative of the European Students Union, so I'm here to get some information on the state of education and technology. We're talking about that a lot to be able to well present the students' opinion on this. But I'm also a PhD researcher on social robotics, so I've got a bit of technical interest in all of this as well.
Yeah, maybe you can write a paper why this one is advantage and what is the powers, how we overcome the COVID environment. And after we have a blackboard in the class, which is only 200 years history only. The classroom has been changed a lot after this, but after we have a COVID, once we have tools to make an immersive way of teaching using this technology, then we have to think about re-imagination of classroom. So flipped learning really can complete it with this video. Video they can watch, if the video watching is better than live classroom listening. And also this video can go other classrooms, one teacher doing everywhere. So that way we can make a new classroom, new schools, based on this, some big change can happen in the education paradigms.
I'm wondering, as a teacher, can you see the students as well?
Yeah, this is the Zoom. The second screen, all the screen, the students coming out. Yeah.
Just in the
Zoom. Yeah. We are making this combined presentation to Zoom. So when the students watching YouTube, Zoom screen showing on this virtual monitor as well. Yeah, so you can make this one here, for example, then this one become very, very big, like this way. So everybody watching Zoom students' speech, when they make a talking, they become big.
Yeah. Are you marketing this towards higher education, secondary, primary?
Everywhere, yeah. Yeah, everywhere. For example, we have something like this is a notebook version. So even not a USB camera they can use. But anyway, Zoom is here, mixed up here, the menu, so they can manage this kind of things there. And of course, another one is a lecture desk. So many lecture desks, we can replace the computer. And then when you teach normal teaching, like here, PowerPoint teaching, then our machine automatically combine and mixing to send this video up to Zoom people. Yeah, so teachers don't have to do anything, just presenting with a mouse pointer. That's it, yeah.
So this would be like hybrid teaching?
Yeah, hybrid teaching. In the classroom, they have a PowerPoint. But basically, we are recommending to show this one directly to here. If they have 10 students, okay. But if they have 100 students, better to show this one on the screen. Yeah. The teacher's face will be.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. So also we make a multiple class. So the other class has a camera to show all the students in one project. The other project, we use a TT, the video conference program. Because Zoom is kind of dividing multiple. But TT has a multi-session, so one session, one class here, another class here. So students feeling they are all together. Every class same, the other classroom showing, the professor teaching this one going every classroom. And the students who is not coming to classroom, they can watch there. The same content there, no differentiation between offline and online. Yeah, so your name? Ruben.
Yes.
Ruben Genesis. So you are a professor?
I'm a PhD student.
Yeah, PhD student. What kind of research topics you are doing now?
My research is on human-robot interaction.
Robot interaction.
Yeah. So how we can improve the robots and make them better at actually interacting with people. And one of the applications I'm looking at is education as well.
Yeah, we can put avatar, make interaction here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, so I will send this video.